and welcome to the third episode of Vaguely Dangerous Wilderness. In this episode, we're going to do the Holdsworth Jumbo circuit and try not to die. Wish us luck.
Cody and Braden begin yet another dangerous trek into the treacherous Tararua Ranges. The biggest dangers they face on the way to the rocky lookout is the extreme heat and ignorant dog walkers.
What's up, G? We're at the Rocky Lookout. We've been walking for a bit over an hour. About a quarter of the way. We could be here.
Made it to the track junction between the Mount Holdsworth track and the track to Torture Flats Hut. It's taken us about 2 hours, including breaks, to get here, which isn't bad. It's almost about two-thirds of the way to Power Hut, so we shouldn't be too far away.
Our adventurous heroes continue up the dangerously well-maintained track on the way to Powell Hut, soon reaching Pig Flat and Mountain House Shelter.
Alrighty, it's 10 to 3. We're at Mountain House, which is 1.8 k's from Powell Hut. It'll probably take us about 2 hours to get there. I think it's taken us about 2.5 hours to get here, which isn't bad time. There's a lot of graffiti. It's
not cool. Someone who came back 3 years later wrote new graffiti by their old graffiti.
It's not good enough. Thumbs down, guys, thumbs down.
So it's meant to take 30 minutes from the track junction to here, but it took us 20. Which is good.
Yeah. Yes, see you at Powell Hut.
Cody and Braden now continue onwards from Mountain House Shelter to Powell Hut. Among the obstacles in their way are the stairs, which are incredibly dangerous and in places life-threatening. They're also really annoying.
It's 4:42, and after probably about 4.5-ish hours of walking, we have made it to Powell Hut.
Yar, the cloud be rolling in thick and fast.
So, Braden didn't want to be in the video log, so I'm doing it. Dead or he's dead, I'm not telling you. I will not divulge anything. Yeah, it's kind of raining looking. We're at Powell. It's kind of like 9 in the morning, close to.
It's still 9 confused.
Told you he wasn't dead. Yeah, we are going to go across the top soon. Probably shouldn't make a video log up there. Yeah. Okay. That's about all I've got to say.
It's, 9:43 a.m. And we've just left Powell Hut, which is behind us, just down this hill a little bit. Pretty awesome view up here. And we're not even at the best part yet. We're going all the way to Addy Wackadoo instead of Jumbo, just because it's cheaper.
Yeah.
And it makes the last day real easy. And that's it. Peace off, bitches.
Just below the Holdsworth trig, having a bit of a break because it's kind of windy and cold, and we need chocolate.
My ear's really cold.
Ear sock.
I forgot a hat.
The alpine environment presents many dangers, even to highly experienced trampers like Braden and Cody. Low visibility and high winds make this part of the track extremely hazardous, but pale in comparison to the threat of a dragon attack, which could occur at any moment.
Two. We've just reached Jumbo Hut, where we'll stop for our main lunch after stopping for a lunch entree type thing at Jumbo Peak. After our lunch, we'll begin the arduous downhill journey to Arifakuru Hut.
Yo yo. I don't actually speak like that. So almost 3:30 and we're about to leave Jumbo. Cody's still packing up his stuff.
It's kind of raining. This is not my phone, wrapped in a sock.
Yep. We're gonna make like a rock and roll soon.
Well, so fun.
After making lunch and terrible puns, Braden and Cody now head downhill towards Arifakuru Hut. The track down Rain Gauge Spur is incredibly steep and presents very high chance of falling over. Braden and Cody will have to be very aware of this danger if they want to make it to Arifakuru Hut alive.
Son of a bastard! Yeah. Oh, my bed fell down. I think it's like after 5:00 and we're almost at Arifakuru, which is good because it's raining and we're kind of damp now.
Hi guys. Yeah, so anyway,
we're at the
it's
hut.
We're at the hut and it's about 6:20. Can't remember when we got here, but I'm pretty sure it was about 6:22, I think.
Yeah, I mean,
We're in our own like bunk room because Arifakuru is freaking massive now. It used to be like one room with 12 bunks at one end, now that one room is just the dining and kitchen, and there's like three separate bunk rooms off that.
It's freaking awesome.
It's got 28 bunks now, which is like the same as Powell, which is pretty massive. We've got a light on because it's kind of dingy in here, even though it's still mega bright outside.
I have a menu. So it's chewy.
Peace off.
Thumb kicking.
Morning. It's sometime just after 11, I think. We'll be leaving fairly shortly. Hopefully it'll be a pretty quick walk to Holdsworth car park. We're thinking maybe about 2.5 to 3 hours. Cody's just gone off to stalk some guys who just popped in here just to figure out where they're going. It's not creepy at all, don't worry. Just before we leave, we'll be filming a quick video tour of the pretty large and somewhat, well, fairly snazzy new Adiwakatu hut. For the record, it's meant to be pronounced Adiwakatu, but yeah, I don't know why, but for some reason we pronounce it Adiwakatu. Whatever floats your boat. Peace off.
Welcome to the vaguely dangerous tour of Adiwakatu Hut.
This area here was once the hole of the hut, and here to here was where the banks were. See that change last year?
Another 8-person cabin.
That concludes Braden and Cody's vaguely dangerous tour of Adiwakatu Hut.
Goodbye now.
Actually not under repairs, it's just being built. Pretty much finished. Wow, such vague danger.
The Adiwakatu stream track appears deceptively safe, but the many slips and river crossings mean that it could very easily result in severe injuries or even death if Cody and Braden don't watch their footing or forget to use bridges.
less than the signpost in time. It's been a pretty good trip. The tops were pretty...
Tops?
Yeah, pretty tops. We saw.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. And the world, I'm turning inside out. Yeah. I'm floating around in ecstasy. So
don't stop me now. Having a good time.
I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go. There's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky, yeah. 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic man.
Time.
I'm having a ball.
Don't stop me now.
If you wanna have a good time.